दोस्तों, इस क्लास में आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड करूंगा उसी मैटर की जो मैंने आपको पिछली क्लास में प्रोवाइड किया है 80 WPM पर। 800 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है, 100 WPM इसकी स्पीड होगी। आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं, बी रेडी फॉर इट। इट इज ए मैटर ऑफ हैप्पीनेस फॉर मी टू बी हियर फॉर द ग्रेजुएशन डे एट गुरु नानक कॉलेज एज वेल एज फॉर द इनॉग्रेशन ऑफ द गुरु अमरदास ब्लॉक and the Shaheed Baba Deep Singh Auditorium. I congratulate the college students, faculty and authorities on these milestones. I especially congratulate approximately 900 students who are graduating today. This is a great achievement for you as well as your families and professors. I wish you all the best as you carry the rich heritage of your college to the world outside. Of the graduating class, over 1/3 is made up of girl students. 12 students are university rank holders and are being honored today with medals. And 7 of the 12 medal winners are girls. These are impressive statistics. As I have said on earlier occasions, in educating a daughter, we educate not one but two families. An educated girl is a positive influence on both her parents' family as well as the family she marries into and builds with her husband. And of course, she contributes enormously at the workplace and in building our economy. Established in 1971 to commemorate the 500th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev, this college has become a landmark institution in Tamil Nadu. I am told that the Guru Nanak Educational Society, the non-profit organization that runs the college, is supported by 256 families living in Chennai. Despite the small size of the community, you are contributing to the state and to society and doing so in the field of education. This is commendable. This college is taking forward a long and rich history of engagement between Punjab and the Sikh community and Tamil Nadu. This history goes back to the period when Guru Nanak Dev, who was one of our greatest spiritual leaders and nation builders, visited Tamil Nadu as part of his journey to southern India. It is believed that he spent a few days in the holy town of Rameshwaram. I am happy to be delivering the 160th convocation address of the University of Madras. Today is an important occasion for the graduating students as well as for your professors and family members. They have strived to support you as you have worked hard to complete your academic program. It is also a momentous anniversary for the university, the story of which has mirrored the evolution of modern higher education in our country. Many congratulations to all of you, especially to the graduating students and to all others associated with this illustrious university. From the middle of the 19th century, the University of Madras has been a cornerstone of our nation building project. It is among the institutions responsible for the strong foundations of education, intellectual advance and knowledge production in India, particularly in the south of our country. I am told that in the region, it is popularly referred to as the mother of universities. It is truly a monumental institution, and I am not referring to just the imposing heritage buildings on this campus. There is a remarkable list of nation builders who have been alumni of this university or of its constituent colleges. No other university in India can make the claim that six former presidents, six of my distinguished predecessors, are old students. Dr. S. Radhakrishnan, Dr. V. V. Giri, Mr. Neelam Sanjeeva Reddy, Mr. R. Venkataraman, Dr. K. R. Narayanan, and Dr. A. P. J. Abdul Kalam all studied here before eventually graduating to the highest office in Rashtrapati Bhavan. The first Indian to become Governor General of our country, the Venerable C. Rajagopalachari, or Rajaji, as we remember him, too, was an alumnus. Two Nobel laureates, as well as two former Chief Justices of India, studied here. Pioneering women leaders were educated at the University of Madras. The roll call of great Indians who have spent their formative years in this university is so long that if I mention all of them, I will be speaking for a few hours. However, I would especially like to mention one stalwart. He was an inspiration as a politician and as a public servant. As agriculture minister, he was crucial to the green revolution and to making us self-sufficient in food. That legacy of scholarship, of learning, and of achievement lives on. Even today, some of India's best-known names internationally, from chess grandmaster Vishwanathan Anand to the corporate leaders, are graduates of the University of Madras. The students who are graduating today are taking forward a rich heritage. The expression "change with continuity" is often used and sometimes overused. But in few institutions, it is as meaningful as at the University of Madras. One of the hallmarks of this university has been its ability to incorporate change even while keeping basic values intact. I wish all the best. दोस्तों इसी के साथ ये डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है. टफ डिक्टेशन है, उम्मीद करता हूँ आप लोगों ने लिखने की कोशिश अच्छे से की होगी. अगर नहीं लिखी गई है तो 80 WPM पर जो इसकी डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड की है आप पहले उसे लिखिए, उसके बाद आप इसे लिखिए. मुलाकात करता हूँ अगली क्लास में अगली ट्रांसक्रिप्शन के साथ. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर.